today is Arty Party. It follows Arty Barker's and then paintball session that we've had up here at the stables. And we brought the Osbox up to the stables. And this is the first time it's been used as a stage. So it's looking very interesting. And we've discovered some of the problems that there might be in the design and what we need to do in the next part of putting the stage together. So it's been used by Mayhem Theatre, and they've done one of their plays that they're producing at the moment called The Sandalwood Mouse. It's kind of about an auction that goes wrong. The side of the Osbox has been folded down, and we've been able to see the auctioneer and have the rest of the actors in the audience, and we've heard what's going on. So it's been a really nice, entertaining piece. Lots of people turned up. It's been great. So to go with that, you can probably hear the sound of the forge in the background. It's a mobile forge that's been set up by Vince Thompson. And he's making steel poppies that are to do with Remembrance Sunday, because this is Remembrance Sunday itself. So, got that. We've had a lot of interest in the way that he's working. He's an industrial artist, so he's very interested in the way that things are constructed. So for him to be here at the stables, it kind of makes sense for him to be here.
My name's Vincent Thompson, and I'm not necessarily a blacksmith, but I would say that I'm a metal artist. And I usually make furniture in a sort of industrial style using structural steel and hot rivets. But today I'm here, because it's Remembrance Sunday, I'm here with the forge and the anvil, and I'm making these steel poppies. And they've been forged here as part of a demonstration to show people how to do it. It's funny because the first one of these I ever made was yesterday. So this is the second one, and I've got quite a few more to do. And they are available for sale, and all the proceeds will go to the British Legion.
In one of the rooms that we've cleared out, we've got three artists. Martin Harris, he's done some paintings of the house, and they look just beautiful. They're just very traditional, but done extremely well, and got a real atmosphere about them, about the history of the house and how it's been over time. There's also a photographer who's new, well, he's just come onto the scene, and he's a local bloke, but Harry Parks. And what he's looking at is the architecture of the area, in this area. So the stable block, how it looks, and also the idea that it could be used for community use, because at the moment it's been made weatherproof, but it's actually not being used in the way that it could be for the community. And then we have Louise Blakeway, who's the curator and owner of the Art Yard, which is very close by Redall Hill Road, and her prints and drawings of people. So she's really building up a profile of the way that she's producing work about people. You know, her portraits of people and the way that she treats life, drawings and so on.
I'm Louise Blakeway. I'm a local artist, do painting, printmaking, drawing. I'm at the Arty Party today showing my work through Cradley Heath Creative. I've got about 10 pieces of work today, paintings, prints and drawings. So I mainly do portraits and figurative work. Some of the work that I'm showing today is based on the Cradley Heath chain makers, and then other works or studies that I've done through my life drawing classes that I run at the Art Yard in Cradley Heath, where I do classes and make my own work. So, yeah.
So it's nice, it's kind of low key, but it ties in with Remembrance Sunday. Martin is also produced a painting about a poppy field in France, and that's going to be bid by sealed auction sometime in the new year, so people can begin to see that going on. So altogether it's made really sort of good sense for us, and we've been supported in this through Creative Black Country, some funding that they've given us to be able to do it, and we're really grateful to be able to take the hotspot somewhere different, do something different with it, and meet the public as well. Another incarnation that the Osbox has had is to be a grotto. It's Santa's grotto. So for the Christmas lights, we did up the inside of the grotto, or the Osbox, as a kind of woodland feel. So we brought in all sorts of dead branches and just hung Christmas stuff around it. A lot of glitter and fairy lights and so on. So it looked absolutely magical, a really good place, and people loved having their selfies taken of themselves and Santa together in the grotto. And it helped to raise funds for the community link that's on the high street and the food bank as well.
Turn a deeper blue. I